Indonesian. I wanted an Indonesian Bible to master a few words of the Indonesian. So I went to the Bible house in Durban. My city in South Africa has got a Bible house where they sell Bibles, specialize in Bibles in different languages. I want an Indonesian Bible. They said they haven't got it. Okay. I said, try Johannesburg. They might have it. So when I went to Johannesburg, I go to the Bible house in Johannesburg. And I go and search for this Indonesian Bible. And I got it. And I'm looking in the shelves, some other books. I see a New Testament, Greek and English. Like we have the Quran, Arabic and English, Greek and English, a New Testament. I took that big volume out and I'm starting to go through that. And the supervisor of the Bible house is watching me. You know, with this funny headgear and this beard. He says, what this guy is doing with all these expensive volumes, because this was an expensive volume in which I took down Greek, English of the New Testament. So he comes up to me. He says, good morning. I said, good morning. He said, what makes you interested in these books? I said, no, I do comparative religion, and I have come across something here in this Greek English of the New Testament that can be of use to me. He found me an interesting character. He said, would you like to have a cup of tea with me? I said, no, I don't mind at all. So he took me into his office. I said, now, you know, we believe in Jesus. And this was something astonishing to this supervisor. And all the supervisors in South Africa of the Bible houses are retired reverends. This was a Reverend Dunkers, Reverend Dunkers. He's amazed. I says, you know, we believe in Jesus and in his miraculous birth. And so saying, I started repeating these verses from the Quran. That we believe. And when I read it, he said, no, this is the same like my book. What you are saying now, that when the good news is given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, in the Holy Quran, she says, قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُنُوا لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She said, oh my Lord, how can I have a child when no man has touched me? Which means physically, sexually. No man has touched me. So the angel says, قَالَ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Even so, Allah creates what He wills. إِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever he decrees a matter, he merely says to it, be, and he wills it, and the thing comes into being. So the reverend says, man, this is the same as my book. I said, yes, on the face of it, it's the same. But if you look at it intently, you'll find the difference between my version and your version is chalk and cheese. You people know chalk and cheese? You know the difference between chalk and cheese? The Canadians didn't know. The Canadians, I'm telling you, when I went to Canada, I spoke about chalk and cheese, they didn't hear that phrase before. We, the English people in South Africa, we know, everybody knows chalk and cheese. Chalk and cheese may look alike, white, but it's a disposed apart. You can't eat chalk, but you can eat cheese. No? But the Canadians didn't know. The Canadians didn't know. I'm telling you. I don't know whether you people know. Difference between chalk and cheese. The poles, in other words, poles apart. So they said, how? I said, you know, in the Holy Bible, in the Gospel of St. Luke, we are told when this good news was given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, about the birth of the Holy Son, she says, how can this thing be when I know not a man? In the biblical language, know means sex. To know means knowing sexually. Not she doesn't know a man. She knows her uncle, her fathers, her neighbors. Surely she knows other men. But no. Know in the biblical language means sex. In the Quran it says, no man has touched me. Again, it means not touched me, means had sex. Both the Quran and the Bible are saying the same thing. The replies to them are revealing. In the Holy Bible, the answer to Mary's protest was that the Holy Ghost will come upon thee. I'm reading the Bible to you. Look. The Holy Ghost will come upon thee, and the power of the Most High will overshadow thee. Now that gives you a mental picture. The Holy Ghost is a person. That's what the Christians say. The Father is a person, the Son is a person, and the Holy Ghost is a person, but they are not three persons, but one person. I don't know whether you heard that expression before. But he's a person. This Holy Ghost will come on Mary. How? See, it gives in your mind. It makes you think, how? like a man and a woman, like a bull and a cow. How? The Almighty will overshadow her. How? No, no, it gives you a mental picture. So I'm suggesting that it gives you a mental picture. You know, how the Holy Ghost will come on her? We know it's a miracle. We agree it's a miracle. But the language that you are using, the language is down-to-earth language. The Quran says, وَإِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَكُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. For God to create Jesus without a human father, it's a kun, he says, be and it is. For him, it's just to will it and he comes into being. So, I'm asking the Reverend. I said, now between these two versions, we are both trying to say the same thing. We are both trying to give the same message that he was born miraculously. There's no doubt about that. But I said, which version would you prefer to give to your daughter? The Quranic version or the biblical version? We are both trying to say the same thing. He said, he bowed his head down in shame and he said he would prefer to give the Quranic version. This is Reverend Dunkers, the head of the Bible Society in Johannesburg.